I took it to 10. Physics dope, eh? It is great, eh? Couple laws, eh? That's a fact, eh? Couple motion, couple kinematics. No force, no mass, get the kinematics started. Make sure you will not get lost, yeah. It's not involved mass and neither force, yeah. It only involves a couple motions. There are displacement, time acceleration, and velocity. Equation, yeah. Multiply acceleration by time, it'll provide you final velocity. If you understand acceleration, it will be much easier. Need a change in velocity, need a change in time period, need to divide them all together, need a grass acceleration. Basic algebraic steps to get first kinematics high. Switch your next schematics high. Starting to calculate displacement high. Use change in velocity over two. Ha.
Champion? Yeah, now it's time for a third kinematics. Another way for displacement. Final velocities not needed. We can solve it easily. Yeah, but acceleration required. Overall, it's pretty simple. 1/2 acceleration multiplied times square gives you displacement. We are finally done. Three kinematics. We will take a break and learn something else.
Learn something else. Learn something else.
Bernoulli's principle.
Ha. Get your notebook out. Time to learn about pressure.
Bernoulli's principle. With height, density, and speed, you can find the pressures increasing the area. That's going to increase speed, but it also decreases pressure. So don't be getting confused. Bernoulli creates lift. The air on top moves quicker, while on the bottom it moves slower. Difference in pressure creates lift. Lift pushes the wings up, unlike my car's depreciation. Kinetic energy increases when the potential decreases. Sum of energy is the same all throughout the system. First law of thermodynamics. Conservation of energy. It's a closed system. Here's the final equation. Pressure plus 1/2 of density and velocity squared, plus density, height, and gravity. Got an A on that test. Yeah, I ain't no loser.
Switch back to kinematics, last kinematic. Kinda hard, but do not fear. We are finding final velocity.
You need displacement, acceleration, and lastly initial velocity. Final velocity squares equals 2 times acceleration times displacement plus square initial velocity. That is all for today's physics lesson.